Big pile of feces in the corner right there.
We know they exist, but don't often see them.
Another bedroom here.
Hoarder homes, so bad they become hazmat situations, and Shelby Township is dealing with one of the worst they have ever seen.
It's rougher than we thought it would be.
Yeah, this home in Shelby is about as bad as they get. Not only dirty, but to the point you can't go in without protective gear.
Well, our Nick Monticelli put that gear on to give us a look inside into this disgusting filth that two brothers were living in.
The air inside of this home is so disgusting, so awful. You cannot breathe without a mask just like this one. You would be vomiting without one. I want to switch the camera view here a little bit more to give you a better idea. The question isn't what are they dealing with, it's what aren't they dealing with. With every inch of this floor covered in garbage.
It's the kind of smell and the kind of scenery that does kind of hit you right in the face when you walk in.
It's one of those stories you do not believe until you see it. A home uninhabitable, and we're not talking just a little dirty or even teenager room kind of dirty. This calls for hazmat suits. The home is near 21 Mile in Van Dyke in Shelby Township. Macomb County foreclosed on the owners for not paying taxes, and the township had first dibs on buying it.
We knew that it would be in rough shape, but we had no idea that we in Shelby Township would have our very own hoarder house, which is what it turned out to be.
And hoarder doesn't even begin to describe it. The only areas with visible floor are still covered in grime, drugs left on tables, rotting food in the refrigerator. The bathroom's so disgusting, the two brothers living here used an old chimney stack in the backyard for a toilet.
What you have is a horrible, horrible smell from the animals and the feces and piles of garbage. And what's really disturbing is people were actually living there.
Now, believe it or not, the Shelby Township Building Department says that this building is actually structurally sound despite all of the garbage and feces all over the floor. They say that this structure can stand as long as it's cleaned out.
The cleanup, though, will be intense. Full suited hazmat crews will have the responsibility of somehow getting rid of all of this, and then the home will be sold. The township bought it for just $14,000.
Even if a rehabber had to put $100,000 into it, it's still well worth it.
The basement is just as bad, and I know it's hard to imagine without seeing it, but the hope is with a lot more than TLC, this could eventually become a clean and safe home again.
It's rougher than we thought it would be, but surprisingly, talking to the building guys, it's not the worst we've ever had, but it's in the top five.
In Shelby Township, Nick Monticelli, Local 4.
All right, Nick.
No words to describe
yeah,
that, really.
Just filth. Yeah.